horse people. This is going to be some tips on trailering your horse and your horse trailer. If you go to my website, thinklikeahorse.org, I have a page on the left you can click. It says trailer loading. And I've got some trailer tips and different things, but this guy covers a lot of things that's a good basic checklist. I'll put a link to his video in the description of this video, but I'm just going to cover a couple little things that he covers.
UV rays from the sun are hard on tires. Considering the amount of time most of our trailers spend parked, investing in tire covers is money well spent.
Okay, I definitely agree with that. I cover my tires. The other thing that I invested in is what's called a tire saver. Hang on, I'll pull up a picture. So they're called tire savers or ramp savers, whatever, trailer saver. It's a plastic thing and it keeps your tire rounded so it doesn't get a flat spot. The biggest problem with this is it's hard to set them up to where you can back on and back forward and stay. Mine broke. I had it on a plastic mat because my driveway is kind of rocked, so I put a big horse mat underneath it. And one of these broke because I was rolling all off it, etc. The easiest way I found to put these on, my trailer is parked a lot more than it's driven. So when I park it, I jack it up, I slide these under the tires, and I lower it down and jack it down. And I do it on both sides, and all four tires have it. I like it. It keeps your horse or your horse trailer stable. It's not going to move back and forward. And when you need to leave in case of an emergency, all you got to do is drive forward and drive away. Here he talks about using a proper gauge to check your tires. My trailer tires, I think, are like 78 or 75, maybe 80 pounds. So that's a little bit higher than most people if they only have a car that their gauge will go. So make sure your gauge goes up to the right thing. Here he talks about making sure your lug nuts are torqued right. Most of these, I think mine are torqued at 100. You can check the manufacturer. If you go 90, 100, it's okay. But trailer tires, because they turn left and right and, you know, these axles are fixed, they don't spin like your front tires when you turn. You turn and your wheels aren't kind of independent or they don't roll like on a trailer. It's just a straight, solid axle. So your tires get a lot more torque and pressure. So making sure your lug nuts are tight and your proper air pressure is important. He also covered when you turn how the tires get a lot of pressure because they're fixed. And when you're turning, it puts more force on the opposite side of what you're turning. And even on the same side you're turning, it's different forces on the tires. Lug nuts and tire pressure are so much. That's why you always see trailer tires blowing. People don't check their tire pressure. They park their tire in the sun. They get flat spots. They don't torque the nuts and they don't have the right prior tire pressure. So in this part, he makes a corner here. And when you're coming off pavement versus gravel or ground, your tires give, but when they're on pavement, they grip. And you can literally see the bubble on the tire right here as he makes this turn. Watch this bubble come forward right there. Did y'all see that? I'm going to go back. Watch right here where my mouse is at, right there on that part of the tire. You're going to see a bubble come out, and then it'll go back in. So on the concrete, it's kind of, see that bubble? See it go away? Bubble comes in. The tire is getting torqued. Bubble goes away. A lot of pressures on this tire. Guy did a good video. This part of the video, he talks about, I see trailers like this load all the time. It drives me nuts. When you put a horse trailer high like this, your horses are like standing on a hill. So not only are they trying to balance when you're turning, stopping, and starting, now they're trying to balance even when you're going straight so they don't fall backwards or lean sideways if you have a slide, you know, a slant load or a straight load, depending on which way it is. But he explains it to where he shows the wheels right here are off the ground. You're putting all the weight on these last two tires of the rear axle. And that's critical why you need proper air pressure, etc. You're always changing forces on corners, stops, and starts. This happen. Here he talks about you can get this ball and your hitch either higher or lower, depending. So you want to make sure I get the right one for your truck and your trailer in order to match it up. You may have to buy a different hitch or receiver if you change trailer or change your trucks. If you put new tires on your truck, make your truck higher. If you put new tires on your trailer and change it, all those things matter. But you want your horse or your horse trailer and your truck in a level stance. He really covers this well right here because his torque, the max trailer is 10,000 pounds. The max torque on the tongue is 1,000 pounds. I'm not sure what the torque is, and I don't know if he explains it or not. But you want to make sure your hitch, because your weakest link in the chain, you have a hitch, you have your ball that's attached to the hitch, and you have your trailer. So if your trailer weighs, I think my trailer weighs 5,500 pounds, 5,500 pounds without horses. I put two 1,500 pound horses. I had 3,000. So I'm at 8,000 pounds for a horse trailer, which is probably what I'd say is average for most horse trailers. But if you have a hitch, I think he goes in where if he goes, yeah, if you have a hitch that's rated for 5,000 pounds and you're pulling an 8,000 horsepower, your ball is different. Your hitch and ball have different weights. This ball is 10,000 pounds. I thought he showed one that was 6,000. Yeah. This ball is 6,000, even though it's the right size. So that's a critical good check that he, I mean, that's a really good video. Go watch the whole video so I don't keep breaking it up. Now he puts a little grease on his ball. I don't usually grease my ball up too much. They say you should grease it up. It makes it run smoother, creates less friction, less likely to hang, maybe chip and crack. The problem with putting grease on a ball is every time you walk by it, your leg and stuff's going to hit it. And it's going to become black or red, whatever the grease is. And this stuff will stain permanently. So a lot of people do not grease their ball. I do every once in a while, but just be aware. I mean, I don't leave my hitch on. Some people leave their hitch on all the time. I only put my hitch on when I'm doing my trailer. My hitch is kept inside my trailer. If I need my trailer, I open the door, the tack room, and I pull my hitch out and I pull it out. So for me to put grease on it, I know it's only going to be on there a short time for me to hook up the trailer and to dishook it. Not a big deal, but they do recommend you do grease it. He talks about these hooks. I see a lot of people putting hooks the other way, one way. I'm not sure if it makes that much of a difference. He says make it this way so when it pulls, it's less likely to pull off because it, as the weight gets on here, it's going to twist this direction. And if it twists this direction, you want it going toward the meat of the hook. If you put it the other way and you pull, it kind of twists the other way. But I still think when you pull on this chain in a straight fashion, your pressure is going to be in this area. But he's saying this is the proper way, which is good. He also says don't twist the chain because chains aren't made for side resistance. I've always twisted my chains because I want the chain. I mean, I guess I could take this bolt out here and shorten my chain. I don't know if I can shorten my chain or not. But I don't want my chain too short, but I don't want it too long. But he says not to twist it. I'm going to have to do some research on that and figure that out. He goes over this safety lock. You got to have a battery in your car with a little thing here. You connect this to your horse trailer. And then if your trailer fails, let's say one of these hitches, because if this hitch fails, your trailer hitch weld fails, the hitch fails, or some part of the trailer fails and it falls off, your backup is your chains. If your chains fail, you have a third backup, which is the emergency braking system, if you have electric brakes. But you need a battery, and I could never keep my battery charger, so I don't even hook this up. And I think in some states, you might be able to get a ticket. It might be a law. But I don't hook mine up because I don't have a battery in there to make it an interactive battery. But if this gets pulled out, your brakes are activated from the battery. But most people trying to keep a battery charge in your horse trailer is, you know, whatever. I mean, you should do it. This guy's pretty anal about his video. I like this because he does shit right. He doesn't cut corners. And if you want to learn the right way, this is the way, then you can decide on what corners you want to cut. But he does a really good video. So check the description. Go link. It's on B&R Northern Horse Journey. If you want to look it up that way. What to check when hooking up your horse trailer. He only has 19 views. But I think it's a really good video. And it needs more views. So when you guys go there, make sure and throw him a like for his video. All right. We'll end that there.